Co-host, and I'm Armin Lihova-Kimian, Deputy Secretary General of the Federation of Euro-Asian Stock Exchanges. Today's FEAS talk is a unique one because last month we had changes and we had elections, and at FEAS we had managerial changes, and today it is my honor and I am very glad to have our new chairman of the Federation, Dr. Mohamed Farid Saleh, with me today for a new FEAS talk. Thanks for joining me, Dr. Farid.
Thank you very much, Armin. It is indeed my honor to be participating today as the chairman of FEAS and to be back to the lovely Federation and the activities. Thank you.
Yeah, and I'm also very happy with this new changes, but let's start with the first question. So when you joined the Federation and the journey of FEAS, it was the hard times and we moved the headquarters and started the new era of FEAS. And now you're winning the FEAS chairmanship the second time. My question is, how do you see your personal contribution to FEAS?
Well, I believe that the first contribution in 2017 and 18 was to ensure the smooth transition, as you mentioned, of having the headquarters moved from Turkey to Armenia, and and then to ensure the governance of the Federation is being put in place in that regard, and to ensure that all elections for the board, for the chairmanship, vice chairmanship, and all other I would say relevant committees are being conducted properly and in a timely and organized fashion to ensure the sustainable path of the Federation. So I believe my initial, I would say, contributions was to ensure the continuum functioning of the Federation per se, and of course working on expanding the network of the Federation and work on several projects that we had worked during the previous, I would say, years, among which was the communication, I would say, toolkit or the marketing toolkit for all members. I believe this is something exchanges need to know about, that if you want to expand the participation of, participants from investors being individual, commercial or institutional investors, you have some sort of a toolkit that you can try to follow on a gradual basis in that regard.
Yes, sure. There are many projects we come along together, and thanks for your team also for that, for the team of EGX. What is your vision for the future of the Federation, for the development, and where do you see the Federation in 5 years?
Okay. I believe two aspects. If you ask me, I would love to see the Federation adopting it, of course, with the consent of the board and the General Assembly and all relevant parts. And maybe that would be part of the plan that has to be presented to them. First and foremost, we need to go beyond the concept of collaboration, capacity building, training, functions. We need to go and dig deeper and go into technology, if you ask my opinion. So part of the projects that we need to think about as FEAS, and whereabout I can see FEAS, is to create the technological, I would say, platforms, or adopt technological platforms that would enable the different brokerage companies within all members of the Federation to participate in this technological platform that can be created, can be adopted, and to be able to ensure the cross-communication and cross-trading between the different members in an organized and easy fashion to increase, I would say, the inter-members trading platform. So this is one technological, I would say, adoption that I believe is of paramount importance if we want, as a Federation, to have an impact on the markets. So this is quite crucial to see how can we develop this platform, how can we adopt this, how can we amend as member exchanges and clearing houses, how can we amend anything from a technological point of view to enable the brokerage houses to participate together and communicate together in that regard. Of course, this communication has to start with availing the information. because you wouldn't see a broker in whatever entity within the federation to be able to participate in the trading activity of the other market unless they can see the prices, they can see the information on the relevant securities being traded in the market. So that is one area of development that I would see and hope to see in the near future for the federation to adopt. Another point, we are becoming very specialized in generally speaking as a function and as an activity. And probably we will need to take again the capacity building a step further and look for certification by professional certificators like whatever becoming the CFA, FRM, anything that has a proper certification. And hence we create a degree for FIAS and for the members of FIAS being approved and authenticated by the different and most important parties governing the education in this field. Why is this important? Because as you can see globally, and this is not a phenomena in Egypt or Armenia or whatever, that's a global phenomena, we get to see the retail participation has been on the rise significantly across all markets. If you go to the data from Bloomberg, you get to see in the US market how retail participation increased from a 10 percentage points of all total trades to around 23-24% of market trading is driven by retail investors. And hence, certification, education, and education in this field is of paramount importance to, I would say, acquaint and educate and train those, I would say, investors with the basics of finance, the basics of trading, the basics of risk management. And it's not only about the knowledge of asset management or portfolio management, but as well risk management is of paramount importance. And to encourage them as investors to participate significantly, you will need to have an add-on in it. So basically the add-on would be is to see FIAS partnering with significant educational institutions and provide this type of certification. And this would in itself attract new members because you're giving a proper value added either from a trading perspective, because here you're creating a global hub rather than a federation by having the linkages from a technology perspective. Anyone who's participating will be happy to participate and see cross-trading happening between the different exchanges.
Very exciting to hear such a development path that you are mentioning, and I am very curious to start all this path together with the new chairman. Dr. Farid, so last year was a hard one and everything was overshadowed by a COVID crisis. How well do you think FEAS has coped with the crisis, and what is one of the FEAS current main, the biggest challenge that you see now at FEAS?
Okay, I believe the biggest challenge, if you ask my opinion, is the slowdown in the number of IPOs in general due to the pandemic and its aftermath. So the point of having IPOs back on track and probably trying to increase it to see significant, reliance on capital markets and exchanges for the secondary market trading and for the price discovery of those particular securities and for capital raising, all the functions that are being driven by capital markets and exchanges is quite important to a very big extent. The second aspect that I believe is one of the areas that we need to look into it, and probably this complements what has been happening and complements as well the other concepts that we talked about development, is to how to increase the participation of passive investors in the different markets to increase the saving ratio and hopefully to increase the retirement benefit by having this incremental saving and incremental investment approach. And this would not be achieved unless you get to see IPOs in the market, companies relying on this particular type of finance for price discovery and as well for capital raising.
Yeah, I see. I see the challenges. And here, FEAS, I hope we can also contribute and help our members to move forward with these challenges and to help them to overcome that. Coming back to the role of the federation. So EGX is a member in several federations, and you personally are involved in many activities and many project task forces in different federations, board, world and regional. In your opinion, what is the main agenda and the development line of capital markets in the world? And what role do federations have there?
Federations have a very important role that they should be playing. Some of them are trying to play it, and some others haven't yet played it as we would hope for. The first part is the concept of streamlining of regulations. You reach to a point whereby unregulated markets are very easy to tap in, and hence you need as much as possible, I wouldn't say to make it easy, but to facilitate for investors participating in the Armenian market, the Kazakh market, the Sydney market, and so on and so forth, to be able to participate and on equal and similar footings between the different markets. So the federations should be playing a very important role, at least initially, to pinpoint the differences when it comes to the trading requirements, when it comes to the coding requirements of investor or identification of investors, and try to streamline, I would say, some aspects in those listing rules and those trading rules to make it much easier for companies and investors to move across markets while having the same rules and having the same aspect. The second aspect, of course, roles of federations would be the capacity building. There are plenty of developmental, I would say, decisions that we took at EGX was based on studies, among which, for example, we had a very long circuit breaker timing in the Egyptian market. And by having, and that was the World Federation of Exchanges, having and issued a study on the timing of circuit breakers and comparing the different markets and how long each market is adopting a circuit breaker in terms of time, we realized that we were quite very long. So in that case, we took a decision to shorten and to lower the time required for a circuit breaker in that regard. So the information, I would say, dissemination and exchanging the knowledge and the roles of federations in that regard is of paramount importance for further development of the markets. And that is the second role that is happening as we speak.
Mm-hmm. So thank you. And yeah, the cooperation is also important between the federations. And the very last part, Dr. Farid, so Mr. Chairman, what will you wish to all our members and potential members for this year and for coming years and in general for capital market?
My first wish, of course, for everyone to be in good health and to be sound and safe in the COVID-19 era and pandemic. So that would be my first wish for all members. Is for all of them and their families, member, beloved ones, to be in good health and safe from this pandemic, and hopefully to see it ending soon, so that we can meet all in person again and exchange the information and exchange all the aspects pertinent to exchanges and capital markets. The second thing that I would wish all participants, and not only exchanges and new ones, I would be dreaming for one day, or in one day, to get to see almost every, I would say, asset being traded in the markets. Not only we're talking about companies and shares and bonds, but as well funds, commodity funds, REITs, and to see all assets, each investor can participate in it with every sector. Not every investor can reach to and create their own sports club. We hope one day that investors in our federation and in our markets can have a portion of their investment in sports, have a portion of their investments in science and technology and whatever. So hopefully to see plenty of assets being listed and traded and to enable investors to diversify their investments and savings for the future.
Thank you. Thank you very much.